A lot of times, you may have to deal with Adobe PDF. For example, you might choose to send your resume to employers in PDF format or exchange documents with your colleagues using Adobe PDF. PDF is an open standard created by Adobe, which became de facto standard for documents exchange. You can use Adobe Acrobat Reader or other free applications to view PDF files. You can open PDF files in the browser, and you can even preview PDF files in File Explorer in Microsoft Windows. The main reason Adobe PDF became a standard for portable documents is because it preserves formats, formatting, as well as incorporates fonts. In the past, it was a challenge to print something exactly as you see it on the screen. So the concept of WYSIWYG was created, and this concept stands for what you see is what you get. And Adobe PDF is one of those standards that exactly supports WYSIWYG concept. On top of this, because specifications for Adobe PDF are open, major technology vendors were able to incorporate PDF into their operating systems, browser, as well as mobile devices. Adobe PDF format is rather complex, and for a very good reason, because it needs to support multiple data structures. For example, PDF supports regular text, as well as richly formatted text, which could be bold, italic, underlined, and include other text features. PDF supports various different types of embedded images, and it also supports different resolutions for these images. For example, some images can come with the high resolution, but very same document could be printed on a black and white printer and scanned using the scanner into the PDF file. PDF also needs to support embedded vector graphic. One of the most popular vector graphic formats today is SVG. SVG files could be embedded into the documents and then resized without losing the quality. PDF also supports embedding of the fonts. Some fonts already come as part of the operating system. For example, Calibri is one of the fonts which comes with Windows. But the same font may or may not be part of the other operating system, for example, macOS, or any operating system in the mobile device. And for that reason, it may need to be embedded inside PDF file, so it can be rendered when document is presented. PDF file also supports international encodings, so the documents could be written in multiple different languages. In addition, PDF supports layers and transparency. For example, inside PDF files, text, picture, and vector graphic can coexist and be on the multiple layers. PDF format may also need to take into account what happens when one element is on top of the other and how it would render it to preserve the quality and intentions of the author of the document. And last but not least is support for interactive elements, as people may need to add links to images or particular text as hyperlinks to the particular websites. In addition to the document's content, Adobe PDF format also supports a lot of metadata. For example, PDF document description contains a lot of properties like title, author, subject, and keywords, as well as some automatically created properties which never could be modified by the author. PDF document format also contains a lot of security information. For example, as an author of the document, you can put some restrictions, like you can allow or disallow printing, documents assembly, content copying, page extraction, commenting, filling of the fields, signing, and creation of the template pages. In addition, PDF format allows embedding of the fonts to preserve how document is viewed and printed. And if you can't find properties that you're looking for, you can create your own custom value properties with the name and value pairs and add them into the PDF document. And last but not least is support for the advanced PDF features, where you can define some PDF settings, print dialog box presets, reading options, as well as protecting mode. There are multiple different ways how you can view PDF files. One of the most popular ones is Adobe PDF Reader. You can download PDF Reader from the get.adobe.com. PDF Reader is free and available for all major platforms. Viewing PDF files also supported by all major browsers, like Chrome, Firefox, Edge, and a lot of others. You can open PDF file in the browser either from your local file system or from any URL. And you can zoom in, zoom out, and access all major features of the PDF file format right from the browser. Most modern operating systems also embedded support for previewing PDF right inside of the operating system. For example, in Windows, you can preview PDF files from within File Explorer. And other major operating systems like macOS and Linux added support for PDF preview as well. Files in PDF format can also be opened and previewed in the mobile operating systems, like iOS, Android, and Chrome OS. There are multiple ways how you can create Adobe PDF file. One of the most common ways, supported by major operating systems, is printing as PDF. For example, if you have a document opened in Windows operating system, you can print this document, and when printing, you can select Microsoft Print to PDF, which will create a PDF file. Since I'm using Microsoft Office application, it is also important to note that Office supports saving files as PDF. For example, in the Save As dialog box, you can find Adobe PDF as one of the options. You can also scan printed copy of the document as PDF. You can typically scan the document as black and white copy or colored copy. And last but not least way is to take a picture of the document on your phone and convert it into PDF. And there are plenty of applications that can help you do it. A lot of times, you may need to convert PDF into Microsoft Word's DocX file format. If you type the right keywords in Google, it will show you a lot of choices available. And one of the best tools is the tool from Adobe. Sometimes online tool conversion represents privacy concerns, though, as you would need to upload your PDF file into the cloud. This is the reason you might consider doing it on the desktop using Microsoft Word application itself. Microsoft Word added the feature of converting documents that have been created in the text editor into the DocX format. So, for example, we're looking at the picture resume created as Adobe PDF file. The picture of the lady here is an image. The rest is just the text. And if we attempt to open this document in Microsoft Word, Microsoft Word will attempt to put this picture as a picture in the DocX file. And it will also try to represent all of the textual elements as Microsoft Word objects. To complete the conversion, you need to open the document using File Open in Microsoft Word. Most of the time, you will get the warning that the document may not look exactly the same as PDF file, which is okay. But as you can see, if we put original PDF document on the right and the converted Word document side by side, you will see that Microsoft Word did a pretty good job. All the text in the document became editable. You can turn on Show Hide feature to show special characters. You are able to reformat and make changes to the document. For example, I am going to use the tab character to move the content, as well as delete some of the characters to position the content in the right way. And once you're done, you can save the document as Word's DocX file, or you can save it back as PDF. A lot of times, you may need to convert scanned PDF file into Microsoft Word. Scanned PDF is typically represented as an image. You cannot edit the text and you cannot extract the text inside PDF image. Most of the time, when you're doing scanned PDF conversion into Word, you need to be able to text afterwards. Most of the time when you're doing such a conversion from scanned PDF into Word, your intent is to edit the text after the conversion. And the best thing is that image-to-text conversion is natively supported in the latest version of Microsoft Word. You can open scanned PDF file inside File Open window in Microsoft Word. When you clicked on the file, Microsoft Word is going to give you a warning, indicating that it will do the best job trying to convert the file from image to text. You can suppress this message for future conversions, or you can keep it. When you click OK, the conversion process starts. As you can see, Microsoft Word did a phenomenal job converting image to text. And if you will put two documents side by side, converted Microsoft Word file on the left and original scanned PDF file on the right, you will see that Microsoft Word also preserved the formatting of the original document. A lot of times, you may need to convert JPEG file into PDF. If you type keywords convert JPEG into PDF in Google, it will pinpoint you to some online tools available. I recommend using tools from Adobe.com or other reputable vendor. Using online tools, though, represents privacy concern, as you have to upload and share your JPEG file with the vendor. Options 2 and 3 on the list would allow you to do the conversion right on your desktop. For example, you may have a JPEG file of the businesswoman that you're trying to convert into PDF. One of the best options is to open the file in the image editor. And for example, in Windows, you can open it either in Paint Editor or Snip and Sketch Editor, and then print it as PDF using native Windows PDF drivers. For example, if you double-click on the file, it will open the file in the default Windows editor. and you can use Print option right inside the editor to print it onto Microsoft Print to PDF driver. Once you click the Print button, you will be prompted to save your PDF file into the file system, and all you need to do is to type the name of the final file and click Save. Once file is saved, you can see the file in your file system, and you can preview the file right in File Explorer, or you can preview the file in Adobe PDF Viewer. One of the concerns with Method 2 is page dimensions concern. For example, as you can see in the final PDF file, the PDF maintains the size of the image and not the size of the printed paper. To eliminate this concern, you can open the image in Microsoft Office application and then save the PDF file using native features of Microsoft Word, for example. To accomplish this, you need to create blank new document in Microsoft Word, navigate to Insert tab, and select Insert Picture from this device. Once you navigate and find the file in your file system, you just click an Insert button. This inserts the image onto the page in Microsoft Word, and this page can be printed, because you can define the layout and size of the page using the Layout feature of Microsoft Word. You also have ability to change the size of the picture and print it in the smaller sizes. Or if you would like to print the page as large as you can change orientation of the page to landscape and adjust the picture. You can also use narrow margins to allow for even more space for the printout. Once you're done editing, you can save the final document as .docx to maintain original editable copy, as well as you can pick PDF file in your Save As dialog box. For example, I will name this file Businesswoman Maintained Print Layout in Word and click Save. Even though both methods 2 and 3 are useful to creating PDF file from JPEG, method 3, which is represented with the PDF file on the right, allows you for more flexibility because you can define the page paper size and place the image any way you would like, versus method 2, which is on the left, which just creates a PDF file based on the original image. A lot of times, you may need to convert Microsoft Word document into PDF. There are two options available for you. You can save file as PDF right inside Microsoft Word, or you can print into PDF driver. For example, you might have just finished editing your resume in Microsoft Word and wondering how can you save it into PDF file to share with potential employers. One of the easiest options available is to navigate to Save As dialog box inside Microsoft Word and select PDF as an option. Once you save the file, it will be available in the file system, and you can use File Explorer to access the document. The cool thing about this type of conversion of Word document into PDF is that created PDF will preserve all the qualities of original Word document. The picture quality will remain the same, and formatting of the document will match original Microsoft Word file. Another way to convert Word file to PDF might be to print the document to PDF driver. For example, Windows 10 operating system that I'm using provides the driver called Microsoft Print to PDF. And if you will select the Print option, Word will prompt you to save the file into the file system. PDF created using native Microsoft driver is almost the same as PDF created using the Save As option. Now, what if you have older version of Microsoft Office or older version of operating system? You can still print to PDF from Microsoft Word by using third-party free drivers. One of the best ones is Qt PDF. You can search for Qt PDF driver in Google and download the latest version. But the coolest thing about Qt PDF is that it allows you to change properties. You can change layout and page order of the final PDF file, as well as change the paper quality and select black and white option when you're creating PDF file. You can also access a lot of advanced options and change them as you're trying to print the document. Please consider subscribing to this channel. Skills that you learn here will be helpful for you now and also in the future. You also get opportunity to help other people by answering their questions and helping them solve their challenges. If you like the content, please give this video a big thumbs up. This tells us that you need more content like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.